We're going to give away some door prizes for everybody that registered. We have some t-shirts and some calendars.
Doors.
The first name that we have for the soulful crossword puzzle and calendar is Ricky Robinson from Highland Park. Please come up.
So you can hear.
Yep. Oh. I missed her.
Takesha Hunter from Highland Park.
Yeah.
January 1st.
They won't take it early.
Yeah.
They won't accept them early. So soon after January 1st for those people that are seniors. So if you're juniors, you want to do it January 1st of the year that you plan to enter college. Yes, you can.
You can on January 1st. Yeah. Right. January 1st, pick it up beforehand, fill it out because it's with your parents.
Right.
It's basically all this information is coming from your parents. Okay?
And that kind of leads into one thing that I want to talk about. An important thing to remember is that I know me personally with my personal taxes, I wait till like April 1st to fill them out. Don't let your parents do that because their 1999 taxes are going to be what goes to figure your financial aid for the next school year. So you want to maybe over the Christmas holidays sit down with them and start thinking about financial aid and working to fill that paperwork out so that you can send it off as soon after January 1st as possible. Another thing that I want to talk to you about really briefly, I think you remember when I was talking to you and I said that your assets go into expected family contribution also. So I don't know if any of you have jobs or personal savings accounts. Let's say, for example, Keisha Girl's grandmother started giving her $1,000 savings bond a year over 10 years. You know, started when she was 8, gave it to her for 10 years. So now she's 18, she has $10,000 in double E savings. Okay. But now let's say, for example, that instead of putting $1,000 in savings bonds, like your mother from the time you were 8 was putting just maybe like $1,000 in a mutual fund, and she has $10,000 saved up in her name, but it was Alex, she had in her mind that was for you to go to school, but it's in her name. The highest percentage that they will count a parent's assets at, this is the most they will count it at, is 5.6%. So of this $10,000, they're saying you've got $560 to go to school with. So simply by having this $10,000 in your parents' name versus being in your name, you are eligible for close to $3,000 more financial aid. So that's something that a lot of parents don't understand. They'll start saving up money, they'll start doing the savings bonds or the college saving fund, and it'll be in your name. That could potentially hurt the amount of financial aid that you can get because students' assets are counted.
O'clock, sir.
Chain.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
We're going to give away some door prizes for everybody that registered. We have some t-shirts and some calendars.
Doors.
The first name that we have for the soulful crossword puzzle and calendar is Ricky Robinson from Highland Park. Please come up.
So you can hear.
Yep.
school. Keisha Hunter from Highland Park.
Lakeisha from Highland Park.
We're not going up the stairs.
Fill it out because it's with your parents.
Right.
It's basically, all this information is coming from your parents. Okay?
And that kind of leads into what the one thing that I want to talk about. An important thing to remember is that I know me personally with my personal taxes, I wait till like April 1st to fill them out. Don't let your parents do that because their 1999 taxes are going to be what's going to figure your financial aid for the next school year. So you want to maybe over the Christmas holidays sit down with them and start thinking about financial aid and working to fill that paperwork out so that you can send it off as soon after January 1st as possible. Another thing that I want to talk to you about really briefly, I think you remember when I was talking to you and I said that your assets go into expected family contribution also. So I don't know if any of you have jobs or personal savings accounts. Let's say, for example, Keisha Girl's grandmother started giving her $1,000 savings bond a year over 10 years. You know, started when she was 8, gave it to her for 10 years. So now she's 18, she has $10,000 in double E savings.
Okay. But now let's say, for example, that instead of putting $1,000 in savings bonds, like your mother from the time you were 8 was putting just maybe like $1,000 in a mutual fund, and she has $10,000 saved up in her name, But it was Alex, she had in her mind, that was for you to go to school, but it's in her name. The highest percentage that they will count a parent's assets at, this is the most they will count it at, is 5.6%. So of this $10,000, they're saying you've got $560 to go to school with. So simply by having this $10,000 in your parents' name versus being in your name, you are eligible for close to $3,000 more financial aid. So that's something that a lot of parents don't understand. They'll start saving up money, they'll start doing the savings bonds or the college saving fund, and it'll be in your name. That could potentially hurt the amount of financial aid that you can get because students' assets are counted.
O'clock, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Are you
taking? Yes.
Michael.